Hello, 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 guys and girls. We're now on part 32 of the walkthrough. Hope you're in for a treat. I don't know what I'm going with that. We're going to start this part with doing a free play of level 1, The Magic Begins. So, at the moment, we haven't got that many characters, but you can do the first two levels without Dark Wizards. So, I'll get a Dark Wizard later on. We'll cross the page when we come to it, that sort of thing, you know. So, free play mode time. As you can see, I've got very, very few characters. I've only got three. No, sorry, four. So, not much variety here, I suppose. But, you know, just use those three. Actually, what I need... Actually, think about it. No, we'll unlock Hagrid and Gripper. The difference in this game is that the characters that you had originally in the level will also be in the level. So I'll show you now. So, Gripper and we've got Hagrid. So, happy, happy days, eh? So we start here in the Leaky Cauldron, as usual. Yeah, it is Leaky Cauldron. For some reason I thought I might have got that wrong. What's the high port fan am I, eh? Yeah, basically, everything that can be cast magic on. Cast magic on it, that's my advice, you know, because seriously, you're gonna need it. There is a lot, there are a lot of stuff to get, rather. I don't need like 76,000, something like that, or 80,000 around that. You need quite a few, say the least. Behind it for now, because mine is awesome. So, yeah, there's gonna be a lot of exploring, lots of getting studs, so sit tight and enjoy the ride, it's gonna be lots of fun, you know. This is where the real work begins. It's not too difficult though. I'm not sure if I should say that really, because that sort of, like, you know, lowers my status as a walkthrough if I'm doing an easy game, you know. This is always a good laugh though. Let's get. Not that, not that. No, forget. See, the thing is now, usually you'd be able to use L1 and R1 to change characters, but now if you do it. Yeah, if you do it now, you change characters like you do. And then, like, when we first had free play in LEGO Star Wars, and it was like, oh my god, this is so cool. Now it's quite a casual thing, but it's still awesome. So I'll show you now. The most important thing to do in here, other than of course getting out, is to get to the, I think it's the Gryffindor part of the Hogwarts quest. If I get this camel here to firecracker. Well, it is nearly Bonfire Night, so it sort of makes sense. Those Americans who don't know what Bonfire Night is, I'll explain a bit of English history. Lesson time. Yeah, English history has it that Guy Fawkes, kind of what year, but he attempted to blow up Parliament. Basically, he put a lot of gunpowder underneath the House of Parliament and was about to blow up both places with marines. But he was stopped, thank God for that, you know. So, happy, happy days. I've done this wrong, actually. Do this first. He was caught in the house. That's never happened. But since then, we have celebrated it with Bonfire Night. And it's become less and less of, like, going around history. Like, traditionally, you're meant to have, like, a Guy Fawkes, as it were, on the bonfire, like a scarecrow, you know, something on the bonfire. Now you just have, you know, it's more focused on the fireworks. And, you know, fireworks is quite an important thing. Come on, work. There we go. Happy days. Glad that worked. Literally destroying everything. I'd much rather destroy everything now and, you know, get fewer. I mean, there are a couple of, like, big 10,000 ones out there, which is really fine. There's one that annoys me, I'll get to that later. Anyway, like, fireworks wise, I had quite an adventure the other day actually when I was walking along home in Liverpool and there were these kids who, just being crazy little kids they are, just set off a firework in the middle of the street. And I watched, sort of in horror, sort of to my amusement, as two policemen then started chasing them, like, along the road I was walking up. I was watching them, and it's like, oh wow, casual day in Liverpool, that is. It's full of lols, so I don't get anything else in here, really bad here. I guess again. There's many times you like, and you can hit, like, these things in here many times as well. I keep hitting that to get stuff, plenty. To that as well, more studs. But, you know, that's enough for now. There's plenty, plenty out here. Love this bit. I love diagonally. Like, seriously, when I first got this game, I was so excited. It's like, this is my dream. Like, I actually, like, always dreamed of there being a LEGO Harry Potter game. No joke. That's what's me being sad. Like, ever since I got the LEGO Harry Potter set, I've, like, been needing to make a LEGO Harry Potter game. And this is just, you know, it hasn't let me down. So that, this is a really simple quest piece. Just wave at the witch, you know. It's sort of like integrating you into the wizard community by saying hello to fellow wizards. And there's Draco Malfoy, so I'll suppose I could levitate him to the air. And Professor Quirrell! Professor Quirrell! It'd be a lot easier, surely, if I just, like, you know, kill Professor Quirrell now and that'd be the end of it. You can go up there. If you find him in Diagon A now, actually, and use, like, one of the red spells on him, he, like, runs away crying. Oh, it's hilarious. That is really useful. Remember that thing there. Comes to that later. Anything along here? Yes, I've got four supports from here. I mean, there, no. Can I destroy this one here? Oh, yes. This, I am the stud king. I'll literally find, like, anything for studs. Studs are my best friend in the world. They are so good. Blue one! I saw a blue one! Where's blue one gone? There it is! I can't let blue one go, they're too good. Another little blue one there, cheeky little bugger. Just there's loads to find. Destroy this here. This is just vandalism though, isn't it? Vandalism that can be used as, like, you know, this is brilliant fun, they can ride on these things and just knock people over. And people don't mind, they're just like, oh, hey, what's that troublemaker, eh? Well, lad, just laugh it off. He needs Hagrid to help me out, thank you very much. And that's Student Impaled, the first one we've got, I think, well, not the first one we've got anyway. So yeah, there's a purple thing up there, this is the bane of my life, as I shall show you in a minute or so, skip these things. All these empty cages lying about, someone could fall in those. Yeah. Is it just me that has this glitch? I'll try this bad boy. And. No way. Flipping hell, that is not fair. I'm not gonna lie to you. Every time I tried using that, it's broken. And now, this is the first time it's actually worked. That saves me a lot of worry in terms of, like, doing the glitch. Maybe because I used Hagrid for the first time. Let's see if it works now still. Maybe Hagrid breaks it. That's not fair! I played this with free play before and it's never worked for me before. No joke, I'm gonna have to, like, get this and then, like, record it. You know. Surprise the game as it were. This is not fair. Not it. Anyway, so, you know, go through the game as you usually would. Bad boy here. Make the exploding potion, as you do. Huzzah! Does anyone else need to go down here? I don't think so. I will quite quickly, though, of course, get this green sludge. This is why I was saying, like, remember the things back there. Get all this stuff here. I'd rather get loads and loads of Wonga, you know. Now or then later. More studs are better, in my opinion. We're saying hello. They've all got such cool styles. Look at that kid. Proper prep hairstyle there. He could be like Darby Harrington, couldn't he, quite easily. This looks so much fun as well. There's some really random vehicles. There's a vehicle as well that you can play in Leaky Cauldron. I think there's also as well in in Gringotts as well. Everywhere you go. Yeah, clear up all this mess. Last bit here. And there we go, the Hufflepuff quest is ours. That suggests the Hufflepuffs are good cleaners and good finders, eh? What lads? But yeah, most of the stuff you can do, I suppose, in story mode, it's just when we get into the bank that things start to get interesting. That's it, come to Papa. All busy away there, eh? They're in there. Important. Goblin things. Wish I had a goblin. I shouldn't say that, in case a goblin comes after me. You can hit that, like, multiple times as well to get loads and loads of Wonga, but, you know, I'm not too concerned for now getting there. Just running a couple of silver studs. Almost worthless in places like the blue ones and the purple ones. Yeah, you need to get all these things as well. I think that should get us a purple stud. It's always useful. And you can destroy so much here, look. to get absolutely loads of wonga for doing this. Too much to get almost. Oh no, don't go away! Oh, I see. That stuff. Any cheap silver studs. Being studist, aren't I? Is that a term, studist? I don't know. Okay, that one here. I don't know, I'm trying to speak a bit louder actually now, because I found on my videos, the audio's... If I'm quiet, it's hard for you guys to hear, and I have to turn down the game audio, and I'd rather not turn down the game audio. So, just to be on the safe side, I'll speak a little bit louder now. That might make me sound weird to my housemates. Okay, doing that for. Can't be too important. Have I missed one? There's one more that side. There's one down here that I missed. Yes, there is. One right at the start as well. That's just embarrassing. What? Did the lady just go in a manly Dumbledore voice? The guy, oh dear. Hilarious, yeah. So you can feed the goblin if you want to, but there's no point after all. You've got Whip about in your repertoire already after all, remember. I see. Come to Butler. Loads and loads of water. This gets us up to the right, I believe. Where's our purple thing? Give me purple thing, there we go. Nearly there now in terms of how much water we need. Oh, beautiful. More along here, so. I really am going to get everything. Sorry guys. We need to make this to get into here now. This is really... Oh, I can't help! I thought this was like in the vaults. You see Quill there, I'm just like, oh no, what's he up to? Crazy. So there's the dragon. That gets us the final bit of the quest, Bonsai! I know it's 70,000 and obviously 80,000 is too much of an exaggeration. It's quite a lot to ask for. Well, I know I'm definitely going to be able to get 80,000 then, so I'll stop betting for now. Anything else I need to get? I don't think so. There we go. Call me crazy, but I might buy some characters after this, seeing as I've got hardly any so far. Then use another character. Yes. Oh, it's so much easier when I just give you a blue stud. There we go. Okay, so 69,000 you need. Almost 70,000. That's the first character you can unlock, Mr. Ollivander. The other one is down here. They're really easy, these characters, and they all require a ducto. There's a little vehicle you can use there as well, which is quite cool. But, you know, not too much. See, there you go, much easier. Tom the Innkeeper. Most of these characters are very bog standard ones, to be honest with you. Why am I going for mine here? There we go. This pink umbrella. Love that very much. Too bad, Wiz. That's just too much for comfort, isn't it? Okay. Whipper, do your thing. And Bonsai. I think anyone can win this pets, actually. Maybe you're a goblin or a human being or whatever, and they'll let you in. Go on then. Down we go. Don't get to watch the cutscene this time, though, of course, because it's free play. No need. What the hell? And the final character, Pippa. Most important one to get, because you need to have a goblin to get the free play character, which the character in the Dark Wizard character that I was good, but I'm gonna have to get on soon. I'll explain more about it later. Do that here to get a couple of bolts, and I think there's something in here maybe. I don't know. Life of me. As you can see. Oh, there's loads of wonga. I think actually, if you are short of them If you are short of them studs, I will. So now we can do it here. make this new power point. There's a purple one at the top, and that'll definitely get you, make you more than secure with how much or how many bolts you have. Let's go up. There we go, see? That's it, loads. Absolutely. Right, let's do that. There goes the dragon. I still want to get, you can quite easily probably then get 100,000, get six figures, which I sort of want to get now that I'm so close, but, actually I probably kind of have to go outside after this bit. And here we go. So we've got to fire the last people level now, which is of course to go inside Ollivanders. I've got a message from Star Pigeons 99. You've inadvertently made a cameo in this game. You must feel so bad yourself. This is my ass, actually. That's it. Yes! Get the blue one. Get the blue one. Oh, come on, if I can just get 2,000 more bucks. Oh, screw it. Oh, need to get that bridge money anyway. I love doing his kicking attack, it's so cool. Like, pucha! Level done. Ollivander unlocked. Tom Linkeeper unlocked. Ripper unlocked. All four bits of August Quest, Wizard, loads of studs. Imperable, so should I get 3 gold bricks in now? House Quest, Tree Wizard, Soon Imperable. Sports Neil's now online, just so you guys all know, just in case you weren't sure. In case any of you were anxious to know whether he was or wasn't. Lols. Okay, so that's that. The first bit of a level done. The first level in free play done. Which is quite cool, you know. It's nice to start on these bad boys. It will mean longer parts as well, you know, because although we don't have cutscenes in the levels, there's a lot more exploring to be done, so happy, happy days. Now if we go over here, it should now be lit up at least. No, it's not lit up. But there you go, it's all colourful around the edges. Happy student face, we've got all the characters. The magic bar, you know, and the crest, it's all good stuff. Actually, I might as well show you the Hogwarts. Sorry, the Dark Knight stuff quickly. At least a little bit of it. I really should sing the theme tune. Theme tune! Okay, here we go. Love this music. So good! Oh, cool, blimey. Okay, if we go in here, this is Madame Morkin's robes. You can buy absolutely loads of characters here. We've got a million as well, so I might as well start buying them, you know, just for the lols. If I've actually got any so far. What the hell was, once we get that. There's loads of random one and Harry Hermione ones. You know, it's sort of like, do we need them? Do we need them all? Professor Binns. I got him inadvertently outside Dumbledore's study. I'm not sure he was actually any use. I never really use him. To be honest with you. As you can tell, he's quite a boring character in the game. He's in the book. He's sort of is like that as well in the game. So you know, no real use. Come on, where's the important one I want to get though? That's gonna be a long part actually. Justin Page Fletcher, they got that little rascal. Come on, where's Grip Hook? That's one that we want to buy. Everyone's like talking around me. There he is, Grip Hook. Only 55,000, but that's important that you get him. I'm gonna get these two bad boys. What's that unlocked? Is that really it? I'm just getting boring now once I'm doing that. I'll leave it in the middle of two. I'm so awkward, aren't I? I'll leave it to another part to show you. Oh, I'll do it now, quick. What the heck? I guess there's a bomb here anyway. It should be a sign for us at some point. There it is. So you've got this gate here, which is very suspicious looking. It's very quiet. This leads to Nocturne Alley. Creepy little place, eh? But there's three characters you can unlock. The first one you need to assemble this bad boy. Now this is what really annoys me. Here is where you can unlock that ever so shifty Durmstrang leader Igor Karkov. He looks sad, doesn't he? Just like a pirate, actually. Very Jack Sparrow-like, actually. Let's write another character here. Let's quickly do this. Bloody Baron. He's actually quite an interesting character because he can perform his ghost attack. He can freeze characters, which I think is quite a cool thing actually to have. So, complain. And there is Shifty Wizard. Another new character. We've got quite a few new characters there, you know. I think that's him there all along. He looks very shifty and he looks very creepy. My citrus Malfoy there. And a Death Eater there as well, just casually walking around. It's like, hey guys, what's going on? Any Death Eater attacks coming up soon? Okay. So yeah, that's the Bloody Baron. When he uses his attack, he can freeze your opponent, which is quite an interesting thing to have. But yeah, so that is the first level done of free play mode. In the next part, I shall do the next level in free play mode. See you then.